Summer is finally here, even if it doesn't look like it at all in Paris. It's raining every single day, but I still thought that I would share with you some of my favorite summer wellness tips. And let's get right into all the things you can do for a summer wellness routine. The first thing you want to do is listen to your hunger cues. I know I talk about having to listen to your hunger cues all the time, but that's even more true in the summer because with the change of seasons and the warmer weather, it's totally normal for your hunger cues to change a little bit and for your appetite to decrease a little bit. So you have to really pay attention to that. You may just be less hungry. You may start craving different foods. For instance, usually in the mornings, if you watch my what I eat in a day videos, you can see that I love making these huge bowls of oatmeal with tons of delicious and very filling toppings. And I love that throughout the year, but not in the summer because I usually crave something a little bit lighter with a little less things, a little less dense. And so instead of making this big oatmeal bowl, I would rather have a smoothie, for instance, where I can get lots of fresh ingredients in, or maybe some bread with some nut butter and some fruit. Those are options that I prefer. So there's really no need for you to force yourself to eat just because you're used to eating certain things or you're used to this routine and you're wondering like, why am I not craving these foods? Why am I not as hungry? All of these things, that's totally normal for your appetite to change in the summer. Or if it doesn't change, that's still normal too. Just make sure that you're able to honor that. And if you're more interested in learning how to eat intuitively, I have an intuitive eating playlist that you can check out right here. Move your body in a way that feels good. I feel like there's two types of people in the summer, those who work out more because the days are longer and they can work out outside and they have more free time. And then those who work out less because they have like way more social activities. They feel like the heat is just making it too difficult for them to work out and they just have so many other things planned that they just don't have time to work out. And I kind of lean more towards the second category, but I still do try to get in one workout a week during the summer. And this portion of the video is sponsored by Yvette Sports. So Yvette Sports sent me some workout clothes like a few months ago, and since then they're the only ones I have been wearing. So I was really excited when they came out with a new collection, and their collection is made from recycled fabrics and it's called the Eco Collection. So now you can have cute workout clothes and still be eco-friendly. Contributing to a better planet is important for Yvette. They've been focusing on environmental protection for years and they've recycled about 1.2 million water bottles and fishing nets. The bottles and nets were crushed, washed, processed, and turned into recycled polyester and nylon, which is what their new collection is made out of. And the packaging they come in is also made from recycled material and is reusable. And the workout clothes are still as supportive, they're suitable for high intensity exercise, and they're very comfortable. So for the sports bra, it's made of 75% polyester, which is recycled, and 25% elastane. It's designed for high impact sports and it has a firm hold, so you don't have to worry about that. And there's also some non-removable cups in there and some soft microfiber lining that can help reduce friction. And on the inside, you have this breathable mesh that helps you stay dry and cool. It ranges in sizes extra small to 5XL, and there are 4 different colors. For the shorts, they're made of 75% polyester, recycled polyester as well, and 25% elastane as well. And it's also designed for high impact sports. It is high-waisted and it has a wide waistband. The fabric is very soft and it really gives you a lot of support. And they also have this 4-way stretchy technology, so that way you can really move in every direction. And what I really, really love about these shorts is that they just slip on so easily. They just glide on. I find that with other biker shorts, it takes me forever to put them on if I want them to be like fitted and to hold me correctly. It just takes forever to put on. But these, they're fitted and they hold me correctly and they support me, but they are so easy to put on. So that's a big plus. And they range from sizes extra small to 5XL, and they're in 4 colors as well. So if you're interested in trying out their recycled workout clothing line, I will be leaving some discount codes for you in the description. Make sure to check that out. And if you're interested in watching my full workout routine, you can watch that right here or in the description. So thank you again to Yvette Sports for sponsoring this video. And so since I do my workout routine a little less regularly in the summer, I try to compensate by doing other things. So I try to do more outdoor activities. I try to walk more places. Whenever I have like social events, I walk a lot. And I also try to go swimming or to do things where I'm physically active. So it's kind of compensating for this routine that I just can't do twice a week. Have moments of quiet time. In the summer, we do so many different activities. We're outside much more often. We go out with friends, we go swimming, we go to the beach. We do all of these fun things, and this is all great, but it's still important to carve out some time for yourself to just relax and just some quiet time. You can do meditation during this time, which is something I've been really trying to do more of. I like to just use the Calm app for a guided meditation. I think it's really great, but you can totally use any other app, or there's lots of resources online, free resources on YouTube and things like that. You can also just take time to read a book, to listen to a podcast, to take a bubble bath, just to watch a movie, listen to music, whatever gets you in this kind of calm, relaxed space. Because again, in the summer, it's all like go, go, go. And sometimes you just find that the summer ends and you're not rested at all. So it's still important to do these quiet, relaxing things as well. Stay hydrated. Drinking water is always important, but it's even more important in the summer, where you're spending lots of time outside, where you're being more physically active, and where you're probably sweating a lot. During hot summer days, dehydration can sneak up on you faster than you would think. So make sure that you are drinking enough, at least 1.5 liters, that's like 50 ounces of water. I think. Do that every day, drink that every day. You can also get some hydration from fruit and veggies that have a higher water content, like watermelon, melon, tomatoes, peaches, cucumbers, and things like that. And you can also make yourself some smoothies or juices, or just some sparkling water with like a few frozen fruit in it, just to switch it up a little bit and make sure that you're staying as hydrated as possible. Spend time outdoors. The best way to get your daily dose of vitamin D is just to be outside, and that is much easier to do in the summer when the days are longer and the weather is warmer. Being outside has so many health benefits, and it's really important that you maximize the time that you spend outside. So there's tons of things you can do: running, walking, hiking, swimming, rollerblading, going for a bike ride, or just relaxing and reading outside if outdoor activities aren't your thing. Wear sunscreen. So like I said, being outside is great, but make sure that you are protecting your skin. You really need to give yourself protection against the sun's really damaging UV rays. If you expose yourself to the sun too much without wearing sunscreen, first of all, you risk getting sunburned, but then you can also have more lasting damaging effects. Like, this can age your skin and cause wrinkles and brown spots, and it can even cause skin cancer. And this goes even if you have darker skin, or if it's a cloudy day, you still need to be wearing sunscreen and make sure to reapply it about every 2 hours or whenever you go in the water, things like that. Eat plenty of fruit and vegetables. In the summer, our social calendars are usually much more packed, and we're likely to eat out much more regularly, or to go for drinks, to have barbecues with friends, or all of these things. And I'm not going to tell you to take away these things. These things are great and you should absolutely enjoy these perks of the summertime. But I do want you to focus a little bit more on the healthy food options that you could be adding to your plate. Summer is great because you can have so many fresh fruit and vegetables that just taste amazing and that are in season. So take advantage of that and make sure that you're adding them to your meals as often as you can. I know I personally eat so many more salads in the summer because I just crave fresher and lighter meals. And when I say salads, I don't mean that I'm just having like spinach leaves and tomatoes. I make like really full salads with also like a source of carbs in there, like quinoa or pasta or rice or, you know, anything like bulgur, things like that. And then I also put a ton of fruit and veggies. I like to mix it up. And then I often do like a hummus dressing. And that's just a great way to get in a bunch of these fresh fruit and veggies with the smoothie I also talked about in one of my other points. So make sure that you're focusing on adding more of these foods to your diet instead of focusing on limiting all of the like summer foods that you're having with like the barbecues and the ice cream and cookies and cake and all these things that you have during the summer more often. Don't obsess over your summer body. Even though we've definitely improved regarding the social understanding of like body positivity, body acceptance, and things like that, there's still this really deeply rooted notion that people must change their bodies in order to be ready for summer. It's important to know that this is absolutely false and even dangerous, and that this obsession we have with thinness, specifically in the summertime, is the cause of many, many eating disorders across the entire world. The idea that swimwear and summer clothing in general is only for a specific type of body is deeply fatphobic and totally ridiculous. You don't need to look a certain way to wear a certain type of clothes and to look good and to feel good while you are wearing these clothes. And summer is about having fun and spending time outdoors and laughing with friends and seeing your family and just creating memories. And it shouldn't be focused on the way your body looks or the way that the clothes you're putting on makes you look and the way that other people judge you for what you're wearing. So unless you're at a dangerously low or dangerously high weight, which prevents you from doing all of these activities, and this is like a whole other topic, then your body size should not interfere with having a great summer and enjoying yourself and wearing whatever you want. Don't hesitate to check out my videos on why you don't need to lose weight and also on the dangers of diet culture right here or in the description. And with that, that kind of brings me on to my last point, which is to really enjoy yourself, have fun. The summertime is a time where lots of people go on vacation, go abroad, or go to the beach. If you're doing that, that's amazing. But if you're not, there's also tons of other fun things that you can do, especially now that things are opening up again a little bit. You can, you know, go to concerts or amusement parks or do things with friends, have picnics, go on road trips, do like bonfires. And if you're taking some time off of work or if your workload just naturally gets a little bit lighter in the summer, then you can take advantage of this time to do things that you otherwise don't have time to do, even if they're not like super, super fun things, but just things that make you feel good and that you just never get around to doing. I insist on this last point of enjoying yourself because summer can be a source of stress for some people who are trying to look perfect and act perfect and have like this perfect routine. And I just want you to remember that the most important thing is to enjoy yourself and to make great memories. And that's really what I'm trying to say here. You won't be looking back at your summer in a few years like, oh, I'm so happy that I weighed like 10 pounds less during that vacation. That was awesome. You'll be thinking about all the great things you did and all the fun you had and the people you met and the places you discovered. That's what you really should focus on. So hopefully this video was insightful and you picked up a tip or two. Don't hesitate to let me know in the comments what your tips are and what your summer wellness routine is. I'm always looking for new ideas. That's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to like it and subscribe, and see you on my next one. Bye.